We had a brownout the other night for about 4 hours, I'd guess, and we lost an air conditioner, and I was afraid it was going to be a compressor. Turns out it was just the contactor, the solenoid. When I was looking, I missed this brown spot. By the way, here's the disclaimer. Air conditioners carry significant voltage and power, and they can kill you, so if you don't know what you're doing, don't mess with them. But I missed this little brown spot here, and I'll show you what was going on inside of it. I've already popped this open so we can look inside of it and see what happened, but this is it. Inside, in the bottom part, let's start with the bottom part, there's this piece of metal, and there's an electromagnet underneath it, and it pulls it down, and in doing so, pushes forward on this, and I'll show you what this does in a second. Pushes forward on that. The spring normally holds this in the back position like this. And when this goes down, this goes forward, this piece goes forward, pushes on there like that. And here's where the electricity travels from up above these contacts, these silver contacts, into the coil below. Let's take a quick look at the coil below. That's it, just an electromagnet and that piece of metal. So it's pulling down that piece of metal. Okay. So that's all pretty standard fare for a solenoid. Now let's look at this upper piece. Let me pop this off of here. Okay, there we go. There are the contacts, both sets. Just this plastic plate with a held a spring on it. Spring came off over here. Here are the contacts that move. The spring normally holds it open, and when the lever pushes it forward, you can see they push in there like that. You can see up here this top set. So what this is doing is connecting this contact on this side to this contact on this side. It's just a switch. It's just a series of, what is that, four switches. And they're just, you know, connecting these two sides, and then you have the contacts on top, so basically it's connecting here to here, here to here, here to here, here to here. And what happened was the solenoid was not capable of pushing this tightly up against there. The voltage went down low enough. This is a 220 volt system. It went down low enough, but it could just pull it barely in contact, and it started arcing, and you can see the arcing in there. Let me pull this out of here and get a better look at it. You can see there was some serious arcing in here, here, here. You can also see it heated. See the change in color? See, it's supposed to be this nice, pretty copper color like this. And you can see these last two sets are seriously discolored and arced. And you can also, I don't know if you can tell, but the spring on this is basically really loose. The springs back here, you can see, are rather tight. You can hear them. Here, nothing. Not only that, but can you see that? This is deformed. It's actually, the metal got so hot that it began to change shape. So all in all, what was happening is it was meaning that these two and these two were not making good contact with their counterparts in here, and you can see they're kind of burned. And in the end, this finally blew the circuit breaker. So thank goodness that we didn't lose a compressor, we only lost the solenoid. But I'll show you what we're going to do about that to fix this in the future so we don't have this annoyance, because it took about a week. I couldn't fix this one. Like I said, I missed the cue on it, so I didn't fix this one myself. I had to call somebody in. We had to wait almost a week without air conditioning, so that was not a good time. But let me show you what we're going to do about it in the future to avoid this problem. What we've got is we bought one of these low voltage protectors, and I don't really know anything about this. We haven't installed this one yet. We do have a low voltage protector on the refrigerator, and it's been there for a couple years, and so far it seems to have worked, because we do have the occasional brownout, probably every 6 months. And what's inside of this thing is a circuit breaker. Apparently made in France from what it says on the side of it. You bring in your wires here. There's a line in and line out. These are your live, and then your neutral, and then ground. And what this does is it just monitors the voltage, and if the voltage goes too low, it disconnects the live wire, cuts the live wire like a switch. If the load becomes too much or something strange goes wrong, it has its own built-in circuit breaker. Not really sure I need that. What I was hoping for was to find something, for example, by Square D or somebody like that, that would just pop into my my circuit breaker box to take care of that, but no such luck. So what this does is this will mount next to the air conditioner. The wires will come out down here, and so I'm not sure if I'm going to do this myself. Again, if you don't know what you're doing, don't do it. Might bring in an electrician at least to show me how to do the first one. But anyway, this is what we're going to do to fix this in the future. Just wire these things into the air conditioners. We have a few air conditioners around, so we're going to wire these into it. And then maybe some key components around the house, like a water pump and so on. Okay, well, that was it. Hope you found it useful and interesting.